Hello everyone, welcome to this Sims 3 house design video. So today I am here on Plymouth Isle yet again, building a two-bedroom, one-bathroom cottage in the harbor area. So this house is built on lot number 7, and there will be a download link in the description below so you can download this house if you want to and add it into the world yourself. So right now I'm actually putting in a boat launch, and it's kind of, you know, playing into what the idea behind this house is that this is kind of meant to be like a fisher's cottage, so like someone, you know, who fishes or something, or someone who likes to fish, I guess. Doesn't necessarily have to be a career choice, but that's just kind of like what I thought, or just someone who likes to boat. I just gave it that name. But because basically the house is built right over the harbor here and it has a boat launch, and I thought that it would make sense, because like after I built like the whole, you know, harbor area, the wharf area, I realized like there's no boat launches, but there's all these boats, you know, in these marinas, because I did two marinas, and in fact this house is built right next to one of them. So I was like, I did two marinas and I didn't make any like boat launches or anything, or any way of getting boats into the water or out of the water. So I built this house with a boat launch right here in the harbor area. So here's the way that boats get in and out, I guess. So, you know, maybe other people also can use this boat launch as well. But I essentially just made like, you know, a sloped driveway that just goes into the water, and I you know, make it look a little nicer than how it looks right now. But yeah, that's basically all it is. Just, you know, a nice little boat launch that's just for show mostly. I left that boat trailer there as well, so you can imagine that, you know, that's like where the boat would go if it wasn't in the water. But yeah, so this house, like I said at the beginning, ends up having, two bedrooms and a bathroom, one bathroom. It's not super expensive either. I think it's like, I don't know how much it ends up costing, but it's like under 100,000, you know. I think it's like actually around 50,000 maybe. It's not, you know, crazy. Still more expensive than maybe you'd expect, but it's not crazy. Right here, I'm just kind of doing this because I didn't like the height the stilted foundation was at, so I ended up deleting it all and putting it back at a different height because it just was a little bit too low for my taste. So that's what's happening right here. That's why I got rid of it all, and then I put the walls back where they were. But yeah, so this is meant to be more of like a cozy, compact, house that's meant to look older, like it's been here a while. It matches the same kind of style as like the rest of the buildings on the wharf or in the harbor area. I also added this little dock here that kind of fits in with the marina next door. So kind of like from edit town view or map view, it all kind of matches and fits together nicely. And I also have that extend out that way. I also expand like this little sidewalk area here. So you'll see I actually like initially only put it like 3 blocks into the lot, but then I actually expand it. So it's like a nice, like a little plaza area kind of out front of the house. So there's no grass really on this lot. It's mostly just, you know, paved ground and then just water. It's like a little bit of sand, you know, because most of the lot that is like not underwater is like under the house. So, you know, not too much land here, but the lot actually extends pretty far into the water. I think that I only built like maybe like 2/3 of the way into the lot's depth. It's like a 30 by 30 lot or something like that. So it's actually a pretty big lot. But here I'm actually doing a little roofing thing where I'm kind of like making the eaves like, you know, cut out so it doesn't have like these massive like, you know, solid walls at the ends of the roofs, if that makes sense. So I'm kind of making like all these little different roof sections here so I can get like the little pieces to kind of make it look nice. So I can kind of see that there. Just kind of adds a little bit, you know, like a little bit of an interesting touch to it, I guess. So that's kind of like what that's all about. Anyway, right now I am going to put in, I guess, some stairs there. I had to adjust the height though because it was a little bit too... It was, again, like the same thing happened with a couple builds I did, or at least I think one of them from like a little while ago, is that the ground was like weirdly, you know, it was like too low for it to be one step, but too high for it to be two steps, if that makes sense. So I had to like adjust it. So the ground's like not exactly flat, but it's fine, I guess. Anyway, here I'm putting in some doors and windows. So there's some doors, some sliding glass doors out the back. There's also a stained glass door that faces the back as well. And here I'm just getting in some windows, pretty simple windows. Some nice large, well, some somewhat larger windows in the front there, that face kind of the back of the other buildings. Like, this house doesn't really, like, face a road at all. Like, the only, like, part of the lot that connects to, like, where the road is where the boat launch is, which makes sense. But, like, the house actually, like, faces the back of, like, the cafe there. But I kind of like it, and this is my intention. Like, I placed this lot here with the intention of building, like, a house like this here. Was that, like, you know, from map view, it, like, looks kind of nice and dense, you know, like a little dense harbor area. I thought it was kind of nice looking. I also put two fireplaces in here, so there's one in the kitchen slash dining room and one in the living room. The one in the kitchen area is just there, so, like, the chimney goes, like, right out the middle, like, where the roofs join, because I thought it looked nice. But the one in the living room is there for, like, because I wanted one in the living room. Anyway, the kitchen here is pretty simple, so you just have, like, your appliances and stuff there, and then the dining room is just a couple chairs. I actually think it might be three chairs, over there. So, yeah, it's actually a pretty simple little kitchen dining area. So, you know, it's a small house. It's like a cottage, like, you know, the title suggests. So, yeah. Pretty compact house, but nice and cozy. There's the living room slash office area. It's like a desk in there, so that's why I say slash office. And there's also the master bedroom, and then there's a second bedroom there as well. So, yeah. And then the bathroom is right there. So, yep, we're going to do some outside stuff now, I guess. I'm going to put the deck material on, although I actually hop over to the marina next door so I can save what the wood material I used on the dock there and then place it down here on this lot. I actually did that as well for, like, the I don't know what you call it. It's like the supports underneath the stilted foundation. I guess the stilts. Yeah, that's what you'd call it. The stilts on the stilted foundation. Yeah, I copied that from the lot next door as well, so that, you know, this house kind of matches the marinas as well, because they at least look like they were built around the same time. So I feel like that's kind of nice and somewhat fitting, you know? Anyway, just doing the boat dock here as well. So getting that on. The boat dock only ends up having one dock on it, because there's a whole marina next door. I didn't feel like it would make sense really to, put like tons of boats there or something. But, I feel like the house should have a boat because it is, like, supposed to be like a fisher's cottage or something like that. So that, you know, I thought it would be, somewhat fitting. So that's why I decided to do that. Anyways, right here I just put in a wall, just like alongside the boat launch there, just so it looks a little neater. And I also redid the asphalt there just so it matches the other lots on this area, or at least the the ferry terminal. That's right. So the ferry terminal has that same asphalt there. So I thought it'd be a nice matching thing to do. But yeah, so I'm also going to put on the, like, kind of woods shake siding that matches, like, the other lots in the harbor area in a similar kind of color. So, you know, that's the idea behind that pretty much, because, everything here is kind of, like, meant to go together. So I really wanted it to, you know, have that kind of same cohesiveness or that same kind of theme throughout this kind of harbor area, because I thought that would be a nice little touch right there. So here I'm just adding some details to that wall there. I'm also going to add some stairs as well to the dock area. And I'm going to flatten out this area here because I wanted this to look kind of more like a little bit of a plaza and more of like a continuation of the wharf slash harbor area, and less kind of natural, more like man-made. So instead of like the sloping grass and sand, I thought that the kind of flattened area there would look a little bit better. And I also put a tree in this space as well. I also put some trees over here by the boat launch, kind of where it kind of transitions to land a little bit more. But I'm also going to recolor all the windows and doors and stuff, and the railings and the columns. I think I changed the color of the columns again later, but, you know, for the most part, just kind of making sure everything matches, and also the interior doors and archways and things like that. And also doing the railings and stuff outside as well. But anyway, on the inside, I start off with just doing some lighting. So I do some lighting in, like, the entrance and the living room and the kitchen. I also do a little bit of outdoor lighting as well. So just doing that kind of stuff. You know, just some basic stuff. Here's the outdoor lights, just kind of around the house here. So at night, you know, it lights up nicely. And then on the inside, I'm going to begin on doing, like, the floors and wallpapers and stuff. So, like, the flooring, I'm getting, like, this tile floor, in the kitchen area and kind of just recoloring it here. So yeah, that's the kitchen floor and also the entrance. And then I get kind of like a little bit of a tile that kind of goes under the fireplaces, which I thought looked pretty nice. So just doing that. Also getting some wood in the main rooms. But anyway, here in the living room, I'm going to get this wallpaper from Pets that kind of has this trim around it, like this arched trim. And then it's kind of like paint in the middle, or at least I made it paint in the middle. So you can kind of see what that looks like there. I used it on one of the townhouses a little while ago, which I think looks nice. So I thought that was kind of a nice wallpaper to use here. It kind of fit the style of the house. It was kind of nice and cozy looking and a little bit more like old fashioned, I guess. Anyway, here I'm just changing the color of the wood a little bit because it looked just a little bit too dull. So just doing that. Some recolor in there. And also in the entrance here, I have some wood paneling as well. And then in the kitchen, I have wood paneling and then also tile, like where the counters are. So where it would make sense for like a backsplash. So basically just doing that. So the kitchen's kind of green. And then I'm going to do the cabinets as well. And we'll get some tile in and things like that. So we can get the kitchen going, which will look nice as well. So I'm just getting the tiles on the counters here, and I kind of go for more of a green look there with the tiles, so it kind of goes with the walls, and also the appliances are also kind of greenish as well, and I carry the tile over onto the fireplace here as well, and just kind of recoloring the fireplace. And here with the chairs, it's like the little dining area, so it has room for three Sims, which is pretty adequate for the house, considering that the house can have three people sleep in it at a time. It's pretty fitting, so it's kind of cozy as well. I like the room. I think it looks nice, and it suits the house. You know, it's meant to be like kind of a small, like cozy house, so it kind of goes well with that theme. But right here, just recoloring a few more things, getting some stuff here on the fireplace mantle, also a bit of art there as well over the fireplace. And and we're also going to get some curtains here over the windows in the kitchen as well. So just doing that right here. And there we go. So over here in the entrance, I'm just going to put a few things in I think I'm going to put a painting in the kitchen as well. But yeah, in the entrance, I just put a few things just to make it look a little bit nicer. So we have a side table, also some curtains, and I put some details in here. So some plants as well, I believe, and just some stuff like that, just so it looks kind of nice. And to finish off, it's not just like an empty little room that's kind of sad. So, you know, it has some stuff going on. I also put like a little bookshelf in that area as well. Anyway, we're going to move on to the living room next. So living room is kind of like a nice cozy room. It faces the front of the lot, which is pretty much, again, like facing the back of like the cafe. But we have like some two like love seats in here, and then also a fireplace, which is nice. I put in a TV as well, and I also put a desk with a computer, I believe. I think I put a computer in this room, and also like some bookshelves and stuff, all the kind of like typical things that, you know, I like to put in rooms in my houses. But, you know, again, more cozy. It's like a pretty compact room, kind of has like a yellow and green color scheme to it, which I think is nice. And yeah, so overall, I think it's a room that kind of works well with the house. And, you know, stylistically, I think it, you know, it suits the house pretty well. So yeah, it's nice. So you basically have like the main living area, like one half of the room, and then like the computer office-y kind of area on the other half of the room. So it kind of like splits up the space a little bit. There's also a side door as well that goes out to the back porch. Or front porch, I guess, in this case, maybe. So that's pretty nice, too. So right here, I think we're pretty much wrapping up the living room. So I'm just going to put a few more things in here, kind of like a bookshelf and a plant. And we're going to move on to the bathroom. So this bathroom is pretty simple. It just has a shower, a sink, and a toilet in it. But it has a relatively kind of interesting color scheme, I guess, kind of like reddish. We have the black tiles there as well, but you know, it's a pretty simple bathroom. It's a pretty simple house, so it's not like anything over the top or crazy, but we just have all the essentials, and then also a few details in here as well. But yeah, pretty simple bathroom, getting a little medicine cabinet in right there. And yeah, so next we're going to move on to the main bedroom. So I guess it would be the master bedroom. And it also has kind of an interesting wall texture here, kind of like the entrance does. So we have like this crisscrossing paneling that's kind of more rustic, which I guess is like a good I guess it's a theme of the house. It's kind of like rustic. And then you'll also see that kind of in the lamps I put in this room. They kind of have these teapot lamps, so you'll see that in a few moments. But yeah, this bedroom kind of has like a more bluish, grayish color scheme. But there you can see the lamps that are kind of, I guess those are more country style, but I feel like that fits in with the house pretty well. But anyway, right here I'm just doing just the dresser, a mirror. It's a pretty simple room. You have a nice sliding glass door though that kind of goes out to the main porch area, so your Sims can head out there and have a view over the harbor, which is nice. So, yep. And the other bedroom has that as well. So, kind of like, you know, the whole house is like a wraparound porch, so you kind of can take advantage of the house's location and like where it is. But anyway, right here, I'm just going to start with the second bedroom. So this bedroom has a kind of a green color scheme. And again, like I mentioned with the other one, the nice view of the harbor. You'll see in the screenshots too. I get some screenshots of like what it looks like what the view from the porch looks like. So stick around for those. They're coming up pretty soon. But anyway, in this room here, we have like a simple kind of like brass bed. So I think I used this bed frame before, made it like metal and wood, but this time I was like, oh, we'll make a golden brass kind of look. But also getting some posters in here, and a little freezer bunny painting there next to the window. And then also a rug as well. And I think that's mostly it. Oh, also a little beanbag chair that's shaped like a shark, or at least printed to be like a shark, which, you know, ocean theme, I guess. So, yeah. Anyway, just putting a few more things in this room here, just a few more details, and that'll pretty much be it for the interior. I'm going to put some rocking chairs on the porch and also some benches and stuff like that, just so some sitting areas outside, which I think is nice to have. So yeah, there's just like a little bench right there, and then another one by the front door. Also recoloring the stairs here. And I'm going to recolor the columns as well, but also putting in the boat. So a little rowboat. I mentioned that earlier. I'd put one of those in because I felt like that would be fitting for a house that's kind of in this theme. Oh, I'm also heading back to the marina next door to get the color from the stilts that I use there, so I can match this house as well to that. So they all kind of have like the same kind of stilt color, I guess. The same. I did the same thing with the wood on the porches, but anyway, just doing some final touches here. So basically, just some decoration on this wall. I'm gonna do some landscaping as well. Not too much though, because this house, you know, is mostly just water on the lot. Oh yeah, right here I'm recoloring the columns. The main landscaping area is right here where this kind of cliff faces, where I flattened out this area to be like a you know, plaza. So I'm putting some rocks there, like a retaining wall. But yeah, that's pretty much all that I do for the landscaping. I put a few more bushes around it as well. But anyway, if you enjoyed this video, I'd greatly appreciate it if you consider subscribing, and also recommend you check out some playlists on my channel. I have ones where I'm just my general house design ones, and then also I have one that is specifically Plymouth Isle houses. And yeah, but if you have any feedback, let me know in the comments below. And if you like the video, make sure to click the like button. But yeah, we're pretty much wrapping it up here. Again, you can download the house. There's a link in the description below. You can place it in Plymouth Isle yourself. And this was built for lot number 7. But anyway, here just doing a few more things, just like a little bit of some plants and stuff like that. And I hope you stick around for the screenshots. They're coming up in just a few moments, so you can get a better look at what the house looks like complete. But yeah, so I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.